A fiery horse with the speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a haughty hi-yo, Silver, the Lone Ranger.
Country, answered the call and smashed the forces of evil in the Barbary Coast. His work in San Francisco finished, Tonto and the masked man headed north for the gold fields and the land of big timber. Return with us now to those thrilling days of yesteryear. From out of the past, from the thundering hoofbeats of the great horse Silver, the Lone Ranger rides again.
Come on, Silver! Faster, boy, faster! I'll Silver! Away!
Large, rambling brick building in front of the river near Hartford, Connecticut. Directly over the main entrance, there was a small triangular sign, Colt's Patent Firearms Manufacturing Company. That was the building's official name, but to most everyone in Hartford, it was the Armory, as familiar and well-known as its owner, Mr. Samuel Colt. One morning in early spring, a clerk entered the Armory's private business office.
There's someone here to see you, Colt.
Is that so? Who is it?
I think you have heard a call as we stepped out of the bar.
See?
It's Mr. Prince. Won't you be?
Oh, of course. Tell us to come right in.
You come in, please. Hello, Colonel Cole.
Mrs. Payne, I needn't tell you how pleased I am that you answered my note in person. Won't you be seated?
Thank you.
I heard only yesterday that you and your young son are going west to join your husband.
I didn't know it myself until I received Gerald's last letter. He's made all the arrangements. Jerry and I will meet him in Independence, Missouri.
Splendid. I know you'll have a pleasant trip.
Did you wish to see me about something in particular, Colonel Cole?
Yes, I do. And I'll make my request as brief as possible. As you know, your husband is one of my best friends. I want to send him something. A gift.
Oh, Gerald will be very pleased.
Yeah. Here it is.
A revolver and plated with silver. And the girl's name engraved on it. Oh, it's a wonderful gift, Colonel Cole.
Oh, more than that, Mrs. Thane. Much more than that. Your husband will understand because he knows the story.
Story?
Well, I've been manufacturing firearms for almost 20 years. In all that time, I've made only 3 guns exactly like the one you have in your hand.
Only 3? Where are the other 2?
Well, I'm sorry. That's a secret I can't divulge. But I can tell you that wherever they are, they're leading strength and truth my personal theory about firearms.
That sounds mysterious.
Not at all. It's an idea I've been telling and retelling ever since I made my first gun.
What do you mean?
A fine gun has the same qualities as human intelligence. Directed by a good man, it's a powerful force for law and peace. Directed by a bad man, it becomes an instrument of evil and destruction.
I think I understand. And that's why you're sending it to Gerald. You know he'll use it as...
As those other two silver guns are being used. For law and peace. Tell him to keep it. Always.
I know.
Rather than risk a fine gun like that falling into the hands of the wrong man, I'd prefer to see it at the bottom of the deepest ocean, or buried under the mountain. Forever.
I'll tell you everything you said, Colonel Cole. And thank you a thousand times. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Mrs. Page. And I wish you and your family all the good luck in the world.
In far-off California, in a secluded camp near the city of San Francisco, the Lone Ranger and Tonto saddled their horses and prepared to ride.
Steady, Silver, steady, boy. Hand in my gun belt, Tonto.
Me oil guns and polish them.
Thanks, Kimo, steady. Everything packed, Tonto? Good. Pretty big fella.
Where we ride, Kimo, steady?
Going north. Along the Sacramento River as far as Marysville. And east into the gold fields.
Why we go there?
I'm with Gerson on some mining properties in that district. I promised to look them over.
Oh. Well, me glad to leave city. I do not like city.
Well, neither do I. Living is much better in the mountains or on the open plains. Come on, Silver, get them up. Come.
About 4 weeks later, that Nancy Payne and Jerry, her son, arrived in Independence, Missouri. That afternoon, as though it were matching human events, the sky turned dull and cloudy. Nancy, holding tight to Jerry's hand, stood beside the first mound and wooden headboard of a new grave. A tall, raw-boned man faced them.
Then Pa was newly murdered.
That's right. I took care of him, brought him out here. That's all I could do.
You've been very kind, mister. I'm sorry. I haven't even asked your name.
It's Miller, ma'am. Brett Miller. I guess saying I'm sorry doesn't help much this time, I think.
Yes, it does. You need Gerald, and I'm grateful for your help.
The gambler who killed Pa. Do you know his name?
A sidewinder called Cass Slater. Nobody's seen hide nor hair of him since the shooting.
Yeah, later. I'll remember that name.
Excuse me, ma'am. What are you and the boy going to do? Going back east?
No. No, we can't do that. We haven't any money.
I happen to know your husband was figuring on heading for California. The gold fields.
Yes, I know.
Well, I'm heading that way. I just thought of something.
What do you mean?
My wife passed away about a year ago. I've got a girl about the same age as your boy. You want to go to California, you'll help take care of her. The boy and you are welcome to ride in my wagon.
Why, I don't know what I could do with Ma. No sense in staying here. True, Jerry,
of course,
but...
I'm a little previous making that suggestion. Truth is, I'm broke. Just as broke as you are. I can't pull out of here till I pay for having my horses shod down at the livery stable. But don't worry, ma'am. I'll find an odd job.
I just thought of something. The only thing I possess that might be worth the money.
What are you talking about?
Here in my purse. Here. I reckon. This would be a present to my husband from Colonel Sam Cole. But now...
Hey, that's a mighty fancy shooting I have. Silver plated.
Is it worth any amount of money?
I'd say it's worth plenty. I never saw a bed like this one before.
Is it worth enough to pay your bill at the livery stable?
No, ma'am. I couldn't take it.
Mr. Miller, you said you offered to take us to California if I helped you take care of your little girl.
Sure, but I...
I'll accept that. Providing I'm an equal partner. Take the gun.
Well...
Come on, Mr. Miller. Are we partners?
Sure we are. Sure.
your mind.
What? You're running a living stable? So you killed a man about a month ago, Cat. You gunned him down in cold blood.
What's that to you?
I happen to know that the sheriff is still looking for a witness for that killing. Now I can tell him one thing or the other.
See. Blackmail. Call it anything you're a mind to.
We rode back to town today with gold in your saddlebag. I want some of it. Understand?
You're even pulling a gun on me.
You split it with me, or I take the whole thing.
Dirty little...
California line. I feel as though we really belong here.
Sure we belong. I guess if other folks can get gold out of these hills and creeks, the partnership of Payne and Miller can get something too.
Partnership of Payne and Miller? Oh, you've been a real friend, Brett. Very few men in your position would have taken on the added responsibility.
Oh, shucks. It's just the other way around. Very few women would have sold a valuable silver-plated gun to help me in Callisto.
That reminds me, I haven't seen Jerry or Callista for over an hour. Where can they be?
Don't worry about those kids. They can take care of themselves. Like as not, they're riding their ponies through the path up ahead. They'll wait for us. Get along, you critters.
Wait, Jerry. Whoa. Oh, boy. Whoa.
What's the idea of stopping here? I thought we were going to race.
The view, Jerry. Let's stop for just a minute and enjoy the view. Oh, isn't it heavenly? The mountains are so tall you can hardly see the top. And there's snow on every one of them.
Yeah. There's gold inside of them, too, if we can find it.
Jerry, I think it was the luckiest day of our life when Daddy and I met you and your mother. You've been wonderful to me. Just like my real mother.
Yeah. And your dad has treated me fine, too.
Oh, well, it's no use, Shorty. The critter pulled the tendon, can't go no further.
Too bad, Cass. My bridle won't carry two of us. We've got a fat chance of finding another horse here in the middle of the Sierras.
Yeah. Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
Look up ahead. Just off the trail above the canyon. Is that a couple of kids on two ponies?
Yeah.
Come on, we'll hoof it up there. This is where my fancy Colt gun gets me a new horse.
The curtain falls on the first act of our Lone Ranger story. Before the next exciting scene, please permit us to pause for just a few moments.
Thank you.
continue our story. Cass and Shorty, two outlaws, are badly in need of a horse. In spotting Jerry and Calisto on the trail above the canyon, they decided to steal one of their ponies.
Reach, both of you.
Who's doing?
You heard what he said, kid. Get him up.
You're after money. You picked the wrong people. We haven't got a bet.
You've got what I want, that pony of ours. Get the boat and do it turn up.
You can't take my pony.
Kid, if you ain't off that car loose in 2 minutes, I'll blow up you.
Now move.
Hey, Cass, look. Come on over the ride.
They're heading right this way.
What's this?
Who is it? A
couple of armies.
Why? They must be our hoops.
What do you mean?
One of them's wearing a mask, and the other one looks like an Indian.
Let him come. They won't spoil our play. You keep these kids covered, and they'll take care of the wild hoops.
The Lone Ranger and Tonto rode directly toward the fellside clearing where the holdup was in progress, high above a steep mountain fence.
Food on the prod, you're asking a lot of questions.
Guess they gotta feed Calista. It's 4-2 now.
A change of mind, Shorty. If we're looking for a horse, this hombre stallion is a better bet than the kid's pony. Slide off of there, mister.
Put that gun away.
You're under a cold draw. Slide off of the stallion or I'll...
Who was? You're not hurt. Keep the other one covered, Toto.
Me watch him.
Did you see that, Calista? He shot the gun right out of his hand.
And it's still falling. See? Down into the canyon.
You... Unholster your gun, or I'll...
Anything you say, stranger. I ain't arguing with your kind of shooting.
Now, come on, tell me what happened here.
Jerry and I were just resting our horses. These men came out and threatened us with guns. They wanted Jerry's pony.
I see. There's a law for horse thieves in California, just as there is everywhere else.
Listen, you and I'll hoot yourself, or you wouldn't be wearing that mask. My partner and I need
to... I'll have time to turn you over to the nearest sheriff. Neither of you will need a horse to go down that trail. Who?
No one was going to tell me.
Give them a start, Toto. Over their heads.
Come on, Shorty. Golly, I never saw outlaws fight among themselves before.
Come on, I heard outlaws.
But you're not.
I don't think those men will trouble you anymore. Their kind always use guns. They've lost theirs.
Hey, mister, who are you?
I was going to ask you and the young lady the same question.
Why, we're just pilgrims, I guess.
And you don't live around here?
No. We're heading for the town of Cherokee, on Eagle Fork, Yuba River.
My father and Jerry's mother are driving the wagon down on the main trail. We were riding ahead of them and took a side trail up here. Then there was men coming up.
I see. You better go down and rejoin your wagon. Cherokee isn't far from here. You ought to make it by sundown.
We will, but I still can't figure out how you and this Indian... I mean... Why did
both you and I have something to be thankful for, Jerry.
Why? What do you mean?
The outlaw's gun is at the bottom of Yuba Canyon instead of in his hand. Adios. Come on, Silver. Come up. Come
up. 3 weeks passed. Leaving Nancy Payne and Calista in Cherokee, Buck Miller and Jerry joined the hundreds of men who previously searched for gold along the winding middle fork of the Yuba River. Some of the miners used a simple tin pan fitted with a rough wire screen. Others used cradles, sifters, and rockers. Two men who followed the river into Yuba Canyon used a sluice box. Anything there?
No, nothing.
Well,
Hey, what is it?
Look, it's a nugget. Nugget as big as my hand.
Nugget? Let me see.
But it's not gold.
Why, it's silver. I never heard of a silver. Well, that's no nugget. It's a gun. Silver plated gun. Let me see it.
My eyes spotted. I'm going to keep it.
That's what you think. Get in that
gun. No, are you?
I'm going to get
it. No, watch out.
Three
shots from a silver plated gun that had lain in the creek bed for 3 weeks. Two of the shots went wild, sending their force against the face of a cliff above the river. The third found its mark in the heart of a miner who searched for gold and found death. That was that, Jerry?
Yes?
In a gunshot. Up the river away.
That's what I thought. Somebody may be in trouble. Come on.
Look, right over there next to the sluice box.
He's dead. Shot through the heart.
Wonder who he is. You killed him.
Good old fellow, Jerry. There are hundreds of men working along the river here.
What's the matter?
I don't know. Must be a way to tell what that course and the reflection of my eyes.
See, there's a piece of metal up there. It shines as bright as a dollar.
Yeah.
We'll have to tell this good man, Dr. Cherokee, and tell the sheriff about it. But first, I'm going to look at that cliff face.
I'll climb up with you.
Well, it is. Right ahead of you. Looks like a piece of tin can or something.
Oh, it's your left tin. It's part of the cliff that's been chipped away by a bullet.
Bullet?
Here's the slug buried right beside it.
Beside what?
This shiny spot was frozen down by the river.
You look kind of funny. Are you
kidding? Listen, Jerry. I don't know much about mining. But I do know this cliff face is an outcropping of quartz. And this shiny spot is gold. Joe, leave me to strike.
What do you want?
All I need is enough money to get to Sacramento. Look, I got a gun here that I'll give you. A fancy silver-footed
crown. No, I'm not interested. Wait a minute. Let's see that gun.
Yeah. It's worth a lot more than
where'd
that.
Where'd you get this? Tell me quick.
Will you help me?
Oh, I'll give you enough money to leave town. Where did this gun come from?
I found it. Honest with you.
Found it where?
In the creek. In Little Fork. In the Little Fork.
Little Fork. That couldn't be true. It was... What part of the river?
Up near New Canyon?
How'd you know?
There.
There's your money.
Thanks, Jeff. I don't know how to...
Now get out of here.
Don't come back.
Sure. I'm leaving right now.
Hey, Jeff. Good afternoon.
What do you mean?
Biggest strike since Cutter's Creek. Make this afternoon up on Middle Fork.
Big one, huh? Who made it?
The claim's registered in two names. Bert Miller and Nancy Payne.
Payne? You sure that's the name?
Yeah.
Found out all about them. He's a widower and she's a widow. They've each got a young kid. Their names are Jerry and Calista.
Yeah, I remember now.
And the name of the mine is the Gerald Payne. That's the widow's dead husband.
Gerald Payne.
He got killed in some kind of an accident back in Missouri. Yeah. What gun you holding?
Silver plated, just like the one.
Well, then that, Shorty.
This is the same gun.
The same? Well, how'd you get it back after that owl hoot in the back?
I know exactly how it happened, and I don't care. I know that Mac outlaw did you and me a big favor.
How could he? What do you mean?
The Gerald Payne, the biggest gold strike from Sutter Creek, I'm going to own it.
Own it? Yes, how can you?
They're arranging for an accident to happen to four people. And then using this gun to prove the legal relationship to the family.
Within a few days, the Gerald Payne gold mine was producing high-grade ore. Brett Miller and Nancy knew that their fortunes were made. Meanwhile, in a well-hidden camp not far away, the Lone Ranger waited anxiously for Tonto's return from an important trip.
What did you find out, Tonto?
Man in town, same man who tried to steal horse from Jerry. His name, Cass Slater. Other man, Shorty Rand.
I thought so. Have you been trailing both of them for the past 2 nights?
Last night they hid plenty of blasting powder near General Payne Mine.
I don't know what it is, but Slater's up to some kind of crooked work. You're right up there. This one of it.
Everybody at the mine tonight.
Everybody? Mr. Miller, Mrs. Payne, Jerry, and Calista?
Me want some Boulder.
All right.
Come on, Boulder, get him up. Come on.
Come on, Matthew. Let's just, we can run for-
Feature of the Lone Ranger Incorporated.